In this video, we will look at coding and line work. This is the ability to add codes to the points that we measure and to have some of these points automatically joined, creating linear features. We will not only look at why we want to carry this out, but also how this is done within Leica Captivate. We should begin by looking at the concept of coding and line work. For example, why would we code when measuring the scene pictured? Perhaps the easiest approach is to think about what would happen if we didn't code, because we would simply end up with points wherever we've measured. At first, this might look fine, but if we take this data into CAD, here we can see it would be difficult to know what to do. However, if we did use code and line work, then effectively we're drawing the scene as we survey it, which means that we will end up with labelled points and lines, which makes it much easier to interpret both live in the field and back in the office. So to summarise, the concept of code and line work is having the ability, whilst on site, to identify features, to label points, to create lines, and to provide benefits both in the field and back in the office. So let's now look at how we do this within Leica Captivate using the new code boxes to code and measure a simple feature. To do this, we'll use an existing job with a code list attached, similar to one we created in the Create New Job video. With this job in the center, we can tap the survey app. Then, in the split screen, we'll go to the new code boxes section. Let's begin by measuring this highlighted fence. We tap the input field, type the code fence, which we want to use, select it, and then it becomes a code box. Now, when we record a point, the highlighted code box will code the point for us. But this code box shows us more than just the code. It also shows us geometry information, which we'll come to in a moment. If the code is configured to link its points as a line, then here we see which line number we are on for this code. And also, we have the ability to enter attributes to store additional information with our codes. Once we are happy that our code box is as required, we can measure our first point. That point is created with the code fence, so then when we measure subsequent points with the same code and line number, they are joined together. Next, we'll use the code box's geometry section to work with line geometry to create something other than a straight. As we can see, we've now reached a point in the fence where it changes from a straight to a curve. So let's do that within Captivate. We tap on the line geometry section of the box, and then we're able to select the type of line geometry we'd like to use. In this case, a three-point arc. Once we've confirmed that, the geometry symbol in the code box changes. Then as we measure a point, the geometry symbol changes again to tell us to measure the second point of the arc. Once we have measured this, then the geometry changes once again to tell us that subsequent measurements will again form part of straight sections. As we continue to make more measurements onto this fence, we can see that we have quickly and easily created a line that goes from a straight to an arc and then back to a straight once again. If we zoom in and take a closer look at the fence, we can see that it accurately represents the situation which we have on site. Modifying line geometry is not the only advanced option that code boxes allow us to do in a surprisingly simple way. We can also use these code boxes to multi-code and to have multiple instances of the same code. A great example of where we would need to use this is just across the road, where we have a fence going into a gate, then back to a fence again, and then we have a T-junction where two fences meet. To measure this, we need to create a new fence. We could use the line number and increase that to 2, or we could, as we will do here, select a new fence box. This shows that we can have multiple code boxes using the same code. What is important is which code box is highlighted and what line number is active in that code box. And as we can see, when we added the new code box, Leica Captivate automatically found and selected the next line number for us. This fence starts already on a curve, so we need to tell Captivate this. We click into the geometry, but this time, instead of using the three-point arc, we're going to use a best fit curve to model our curve over multiple points. So we'll select that and then press OK. Now we can see that our geometry in the code box is showing that it's a multiple point curve. So as we measure a point, we can see that that geometry is telling us that we're continuing our multiple point or best fit curve. After a few measurements, we realize that we're now getting to the point where the fence and the gate are connected. Then after that, we actually have a connection between the gate and a new fence. So let's see how we can handle this within Leica Captivate. The first thing we need to do is to prepare a gate code box. Once we have that, we can use the new function, multi-on, to select multiple codes to be used at the same time. Turning Captivate's coding into multiple coding allows us to use checkboxes to select which codes we would like to be stored. Here, that is our new gate and our existing fence. It is worth noting what Captivate will actually do when we press measure. It will make one measurement, but store it twice, creating two points with different codes. Now, as these two points are in identical positions and any lines going through them will truly intersect in 3D, it has been checked and does not cause problems in CAD, for example, due to crossing brake lines. So now, when we press measure, we know that both codes will be used. We can notice that once the measurement is stored, multi-mode is switched back off because in most cases, multiple coding is only required one shot at a time. However, in this situation, we straight away need to turn multiple coding back on as we are now measuring where the other side of the gate meets our new fence string. So first, we'll use the plus button to create fence line number 3. Then we'll turn multi-coding back on, activate the gate code box as well as the fence, and then press measure to store our second point on our gate and to begin our third fence line. Here, it is worth noting that whichever code box was highlighted when we press measure jumps to the top of our code box list. Here, that was gate, but we want to use fence line number 3. So we tap on that box before we press measure to continue our fence line. The next point that we want to measure is another point that requires multiple codes, although in this instance, it's actually the same code twice because it is our fence T-junction. But this doesn't matter to Captivate. We do the same process. We add the new code box, we turn on multiple coding, we select the codes that we want to store and press measure. Then we can choose which of the fence lines we'd like to continue. Here, we'll continue fence 3 as the code box is already highlighted. Then, after we've finished that line, we can simply tap on the code box for fence line 4 and measure the remaining points on that one too. Once we've measured the final points onto that fence line, we can now look at two more features. First, using codes that weren't already in the code list, and then surveying a line that closes onto itself. And actually, we will use this pond as an example for both of these. As we start typing the code pond, we notice that it's not in the drop-down list. That's because it doesn't exist. But it's not a problem. We can just press enter to add it to the code list. However, because this is a new code, it is initially added simply as a point, as we can see from the geometry. However, if we tap that, we can change it. Because the pond is in a regular shape, we'll use the spline functionality. With that selected, we can begin to measure our pond. As measuring points to the highlighted code box to create a line is nothing new and stuff we've already covered in this video, let's just measure the first couple of points and then skip ahead to a location where the pond is more regular and we want to switch back to using straight segments again, which is easily done by entering into the geometry and selecting end spline. Now any points we measure will be added as straight segments. As we have now come completely around the pond, back towards where we have started, it makes sense to close the line. So once again, we enter geometry, but this time we choose the close line function. Now, when we press measure, this last point will be added, but the line will actually extend beyond this point and close back onto the very first point. Next, we will use one of the biggest benefits of coding and line work. We will review our data using the 3D viewer. Pictured, we can see the scene that we're attempting to survey. Obviously, we haven't surveyed the road, but everything else should have been measured. But as we pan around in the 3D viewer, we realize that we've actually missed something, a tree. It's a large tree, and it certainly should be surveyed, which actually brings us on to the final feature to look at, coding and measuring a single, simple point. As before, we tap into the input field and start to type the code we wish to use. Then when we select this, the code box is created for us. We can see it is created as a point that will not start a line, and this time that is correct. So we leave it as it is and just press measure. And with that, we have now finished this scene for this video. However, we will look at measuring the road and doing something called auto survey in the next Coding and Linework video.